Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about ICD-11, that is International Classification of Disorders, 11th edition on psychiatric disorders, also called as mental, behavioural or neurodevelopmental disorder. I'm Dr. Suresh Badadmet, Professor of Psychiatry, working at NIMHANS, Bangalore. Before I start my presentation, I would like to place this disclaimer. This presentation is for academic and training purpose only, not for clinical opinion or legal opinion. For clinical opinion, please do contact a psychiatrist, and for legal opinion, advocate. Conflict of interest? None. In this video, I'm going to discuss about what are the highlights of ICD-11, how to approach ICD-11 using the digital format, which is the mainstay of ICD-11. That means digital innovation is there in ICD-11. Further, I'll be focusing more on the chapter 6 on psychiatric disorders. As I mentioned, is also called as mental, behavioral or neurodevelopmental disorder. Let's look into ICD-11. International Classification of Disease, that is basically a globally used diagnostic tool for epidemiology, health management and clinical purposes. And this is managed by World Health Organization with the main aim of comparing the statistics for the cause of mortality and morbidity between the region and also across time. What is the utility of this ICD-11? Basically, as I mentioned, for mortality reporting and morbidity reporting, to know if there is any intervention is done, whether the mortality decreased, whether the morbidity decreased within the region, across the region, and across time. Further, cancer registry, antimicrobial resistance coding has been done, assessing functionality and disability, which is a main aim of World Health Organization, which is looking into the WHODAS, that is World Health Organization Disability Assessment Scale. Further, the first time in ICD-11, coding of traditional medicine has been brought in. Further, safety and quality control is very essential. Along with this, if you have a classificator system, you know the prevalence of illness and also the mortality and morbidity, you'll be able to allocate the resources. At the same time, if you are conducting any research and clinical trial, it will be applicable not only in that region, and you'll be able to apply in the other region also. Basically, you are standardizing the diagnosis and management. Further, understanding the disease process, history of the disease, services planning, management of diseases and guideline. If you look into World Health Organization, they have given various management. Basically, with regard to illness, with regard to a system, they have given. Further, ICD-11 coding is widely used across the globe for insurance and reimbursement purposes. That means ICD-11 is playing an important role now and also in the near future. Who is using this ICD-11? Of course, doctors, nurses, researchers, medical record department, pharmacist, hospital administrator, policy makers, because you want to know what is the diagnosis, how the diagnosis is made, what are the requirements it should be there, insurance company, further drug companies, device manufacturing companies, health coders, financing, funders, biotechnologists, healthcare workers, and others who are working in the healthcare industry. For example, COVID-19, which has been a pandemic, if you would like to say, like suppose COVID Delta, what are the signs and symptoms? What should be the genetic coding of this? How it has to be diagnosed? What is the sequencing? All those the WHO is able to understand, and it is able to send the information to the developing countries, which may not be able to have such a wonderful labs or support. So World Health Organization is playing a crucial role here. So many of the healthcare workers rely on World Health Organization for standardizing of the diagnosis, management, and also if there is any preventive measures can be taken. So in this background, ICD-11 is considered as a common standards for a connected world. As you know, internet has connected across the world. Now, we should know, if I say COVID-19 means which is the version? What is the infection? Is it Delta? Is it Epsilon? Or else Omicron? So which is happening in which part of the world? What is the management? What should be the vaccine? When I say COVID-19, whichever is the causes of these subtypes, the management should be able to understand, and globally it can be used uniformly, whatever has been observed in the research. How to approach ICD-11? If you type ICD-11 in the Google browser, the first one which is available, that is considered as the ICD-11, which has been shown by the Google browser. And the link is icd.who.int. So this is the browser which will be used to know about the ICD-11. So this is how it looks when it is searched on the Google engine. And in the first one is the ICD-11 browser. So that browser will be used to understand, to learn about ICD-11. And if you look at this, it is a tabular column. You'll be able to see the ICD-11 different forms have been clearly mentioned. And here you can see from the disease coding of all medical illnesses from 01 to 014 here, further from 14 to 26 and two subtypes. Hence, ICD-11 has 26 chapter and two supplementary sections. The first supplementary section is with regard to functioning assessment. That is basically assessment of functioning and disability. And the second one is extension codes. This extension codes adds dimensionality to the ICD-11. ICD-10 has been criticized because it is highly categorical in nature. It says if you have three symptoms or four symptoms, you'll be considered as illness or not. Whereas here, this chapter adds dimensionality, severity of the illness, course of the illness, onset, timeline of the illness, diagnosis certainty, whether it is provisional diagnosis or confirmed diagnosis, and the diagnosis timing, when the diagnosis is made. So these kinds of characters add dimensionality to the ICD-11. And this, although the categorical nature has been kept, but there is an attempt to make into a dimensional in nature. Although ICD-11 and DSM-5 want to be on the same page, there has been attempt to see whether we'll be able to make a similar kind of diagnostic or classificator system both in DSM-5 and also ICD-11. The attempt is approximately maybe 50 to 70% is successful. However, there is a large differences continue to exist. Let's look into the new chapters introduced into ICD-11. The first one is the chapter 3 has been added, that is disorders of blood and blood forming organs. So this has been a separate chapter has been added. Further, chapter 4, disorders of immune system has been considered here. And further, disorders of sleep-wake disorders has been considered in chapter 7. And this was earlier under the psychiatric ICD-10, in that it was there, but now it has been given a separate chapter. Further, chapter 17, sexual health has been brought into it, along with this gender incongruence, basically transgender. Those have been given a separate chapter. Again, it has been moved out of the mental disorders. Chapter 21 is a separate category where symptoms, signs or clinical findings nowhere else classified has been given. And finally, chapters 26 talks about traditional medicine coding. So these are the new 6 chapters have been added. Added means some of them in removed from certain categories of the chapter and given a separate chapter. Now let's look into the ICD-11 highlights. This is the 11th revision, contains 17,000 unique codes, more than 120,000 codable terms. It is entirely digital. As I mentioned, this world is digital, and hence ICD-11 is going digital. And it has the state-of-the-art coding tools have been introduced here. And now it interprets more than 1.6 million terms. That is the best part of ICD-11. That means if you're able to make a diagnosis, it will be at the precision, you will be able to communicate what you are telling to the other part of the world, telling that, yes, I have made a diagnosis of schizophrenia, severe, moderate, whether it is treatment resistant or not. Those kinds of clear-cut terms have been introduced in ICD-11, and it is a clearly digital world. And also it has end-to-end digital solution. Here API will be distributed. That is, API means application programming interface. tools online and offline will be distributed. This means, suppose if you have already have a coding system, diagnosis, API will be distributed free of cost. That is application programming interface. Suppose you have a software for your hospital and now you have already have the diagnostic system or else coding system under ICD-10. Now, in ICD-11, this application programming interface will be given free of cost. Even the Excels will be provided and there are some of them available online now. At the same time, local deployment option for ICD-11 has been given. That is API for Docker. Docker is a container which runs both Windows and also the Linux system. And further, separate Windows or Linux APIs will be distributed. That means ICD-11 is completely going digital. Further, implementation package to facilitate the transition from ICD-10 to ICD-11 will be made easy through World Health Organization. Further, up-to-date scientific knowledge has been brought in. Further, ICD-11 is accessible to everybody. That means it will be available online, and if you want to copy it and make it offline, is also made available. It's a short period, it will be available even offline. That means the books will be available, digital coding format will be available, at the same time browsers will be available. Already ICD-11 browser is there, which I showed you. ICD-11 enables for the first time the coding of traditional medicine. But however, what is the licensing of ICD? That means ICD-11, whether it is paid or it has to be given free. As World Health Organization, it has distributed under the Creative Common Attribution, no derivatives under 3.0 IGO license. That means it is free to share, copy and redistribute. But you need to give the attribution to the World Health Organization. That means appropriate credit has to be given to World Health Organization and it should be non-commercial, no derivatives. That means you are not going to make any changes to the ICD-11. If you are making it, you need to discuss, take permission from WHO. Moving to the chapter 6, that is psychiatric disorder. As chapter 6 has been named as mental, behavioral or neurodevelopmental disorder, actually this would have been given simply a psychiatric disorder would have been the best, or psychiatric illness. The word mental, behavioral or neurodevelopmental disorders is very complicated. The word mental has a stigma attached to it. I would have preferred psychiatric illness. This is my personal opinion. Once you type ICD-11 in the Google browser, this is the landing page. In this landing page, ICD-11, you can see the browser. This is the ICD-11 browser. If you click this ICD-11 browser, you will see ICD-11 browser in a tabular format from chapter 1 to chapter 26 with the two subcategories. Here, psychiatric disorder is placed in chapter 6. That is mental, behavioral or neurodevelopmental disorder. This is the chapter 6 which majority of the psychiatric illnesses are kept here. Some of them are moved out. Let's discuss all of them. This is how the ICD-11 classification of mental and behavioral disorder has been considered. And if you look at this ICD-11 coding, they are basically alphanumeric, but it has gone completely digital. First character is the chapter. And for psychiatric disorder, it is 6 because we are in the chapter 6. Further, second character is a letter, that is alphabets. So here I'll show you that there are 4 alphabets you need to remember, A, B, C and D. And depending upon them, it will be classified. And hierarchical relations are retained in the 4 character code level. After the 4 character code level, the dimensionality starts cropping up. That means the ICD-11 has made an attempt to move into dimensional picture, similar to DSM-5. But however, the categorical nature continues to exist here. Further, ICD-11 has taken a major paradigm shift. Here, they have decided to remove O and I from coding. The simple reason is O and I during coding, it will be misinterpreted as 0 and 1, or 0, 1 will be misinterpreted as O and I. Hence, they have decided to remove O and I for coding. Hence, here and afterwards, no need to discuss about O and I during coding. Once you click chapter 6, these are the various chapter 18 of the psychiatric disorders have been placed. If you look at that ABCD which I mentioned, they are present here. As you see, the chapter 6 is the first letter of all psychiatric disorder. 6 is the first one. A, that is, the alphabets will be the second character. A for severe mental disorder, B for anxiety disorders, C, which is basically talking about elimination disorder, bodily experiences, impulse control disorder, those kind of things will come, and D for personality disorders and organic disorders come into D. However, the classificatory system appears to be different from ICD-10. ICD-10 had a different category and it has separately had a child and adolescent. Here, they are completely mixed within the whole category. Here, in ICD-10, there were only 10 chapters. Here, 18 chapters have been given. That means some of them have been given, various important significance have been added. Let's move into each one of these section and discuss how they have been placed. That is the objective of this video. Let's move into chapter 6, A0. A0 is basically, we are talking about neurodevelopmental disorder. That means that has been given very importance here. As you look into 6A00, you can look into the intellectual developmental disorder, speech and language disorder. 02 is basically autism spectrum disorder. 3 is developmental learning disorder, developmental motor coordination disorder, A4, and 5 is ADHD and stereotype movement disorder. So 6A is completely for neurodevelopmental disorders. That means it starts telling that neurodevelopmental disorder is the one where this mental, behavioral or neurodevelopmental disorder have been given importance in psychiatry. Moving to 6A2, that is A2 is the chapter which has been considered here. Here, A2 starts with schizophrenia. Here, from comparing to ICD-10, in ICD-11, similar to DSM-5, they have completely removed all categories. Here, the schizophrenia is mild, moderate, severe. So, the completely dimensional picture has been taken into consideration. The paranoid, undifferentiated schizophrenia, all those hebephrenic schizophrenia have been removed. Similar to DSM-5, it is just a schizophrenia. However, mild, moderate, severe, and those dimensionality has been added. Post dimensionality has been brought in. Various drug induced or not, all those kind of things will be considered here. 6A21 is for schizoaffective disorder and schizotypal disorder. And 23 is for acute and transient psychotic disorder, delusional disorder, and also symptomatic manifestation of primary psychotic disorder has been added, which was not there. So these are the category under psychosis. But as you see, there is something called as 2Y and 2Z in the end. What is this 2Y and 2Z? They are basically unspecified otherwise. So as you know, earlier we used to say psychosis, not otherwise specified or unspecified psychosis. Here, the 2Y is not otherwise specified, Z is unspecified. So whenever you code for unspecified, it will be Z. Z will be taken into consideration. Y will be considered for not otherwise specified. Moving to 6A4, it is for catatonia and other mental disorders. Again, here there have been classification which has been considered as catatonia induced psychoactive substance and medication. That is basically for medication and other condition, the catatonia has been brought in here. So again, here there is a Y and Z. Y is basically not otherwise specified. Z is for unspecified. 6A6 talks about bipolar disorder. Here, bipolar type 1, type 2, and cyclothymic disorder has been considered. Moving to A7, here it talks about single depressive episode, recurrent depressive episode, dysthymic disorder, mixed depressive and anxiety disorder has been brought in here. Moving to the A8, here in this, another important dimensionality has been brought in into ICD-11. Here, the diagnosis will be added depending upon depression with prominent anxiety symptoms, panic attacks in mood symptoms, mood episodes, further current depressive episode persistent if it is there for more than 2 years, current depressive episode with melancholia symptoms, rapid cycling comes under A8. So there has been some differences from ICD-10 to ICD-11. Moving to B. B is basically for anxiety disorders. As you can see, it starts with generalized anxiety disorder, panic disorder, agoraphobia, specific phobia, social anxiety disorder, separation anxiety disorder, selective mutism has been coming to picture here. But however, OCD has been moved out. So OCD comes into B2. OCD, body dysmorphophobia, olfactory reference syndrome, hypochondriasis, hoarding disorder, Body-focused repetitive behavior disorders like trichotillomania, excoriation has been considered here. Again, of course, the end will be Y and Z. Y is basically for not otherwise specified, and Z is for unspecified. Moving to B4, it is basically for trauma-focused. Here, PTSD comes in, complex PTSD, prolonged grief disorder, adjustment disorder is being brought here. Further, reactive adjustment disorder, disinhibited social engagement disorder has been brought in here, and it is based upon various research findings. Further, if you move to B6, it is of dissociative neurological disorder. That means, as you considered earlier, maybe hysteria, those kind of things. Here it is dissociative neurological disorder, and 80 is for feeding or eating disorders has been considered. Of course, they have brought in something called as feeding disorder. I don't know, it would have been eating disorder is well known across the world or globally, that would have been kept. Further, C is for elimination disorder and disorders of bodily distress and bodily experiences. Disorders due to substance use, that is the major category in C. Substance C, you can clearly remember. Disorders due to addictive behavior. Here, addictive behavior too has been brought in. Gambling and gaming has been brought here. Open over a period of time. Further, other behavioral disorders, addictive behaviors can be brought in here. Impulse control disorder has been added. Disruptive behavior or dissocial disorders have been brought into C0. Further, if you move into D, as I mentioned, personality disorder, paraphilic disorder, factitious disorder, neurocognitive disorder, dementia comes into D. However, in personality disorder, there has been a major change similar to DSM-5. In personality disorder, as the research have clearly indicated, pure form of personality disorder is very rarely seen. It will be considered as a personality disorder, mild, moderate, severe, and depending upon the subtypes, it will be considered. Earlier, the subtype were A, B, C, which has been completely removed. Here, depending upon the predominant clusters, it will be considered. And that is a difference from the earlier ICD-10. Moving to E0, that is mental or behavioral disorder associated with pregnancy, childbirth, and puerperium. Here, without psychotic symptoms will be the first one, with psychotic symptoms will be the second one. So, see, perinatal related issues have been given importance and it is considered as E0. Further, some of the chapters have been moved out from the ICD-10. That is sleep-wake disorder, that is chapter 7, sexual dysfunction, chapter 17, gender incongruence comes into sexual dysfunction. That is basically, if you are looking into transgender, those kind of disorders have been moved out. To conclude, my dear friends, ICD-11 allows systematic reporting, recording, analysis, interpretation, and comparison of mortality and morbidity data across the countries, across the regions, and across the same region over a period of time. So that gives an important standard across globally. And in the next video, I'll be discussing about what are the differences between ICD-11 and ICD-10. Thank you very much for giving your valuable time. Stay safe.